गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, सी वन मोर क्वेश्चन ऑफ डबल कॉलम कैश बुक, क्वेश्चन नंबर 8th बी ऑफ डीके गोयल। प्रिपेयर टू कॉलम कैश बुक फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग इन्फॉर्मेशन। जून 1 कैश इन हैंड एंड कैश एट बैंक बोथ बैलेंसेस आर गिवन। सो कैश बैलेंस एज वेल एज बैंक बैलेंस, बोथ बैलेंसेस विल कम इन डेबिट साइड। जून 1 बैलेंस ब्रॉट डाउन, कैश बैलेंस इज 2800 दैट विल कम इन कैश कॉलम एंड बैंक बैलेंस इज 7000 दैट विल कम इन बैंक कॉलम। ओके, इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई टोल्ड यू दैट समटाइम्स बैंक बैलेंस मे बी क्रेडिट बैलेंस एज वेल एज overdraft balance. If bank balance will be credit or and overdraft, in that particular case you will write balance of bank in credit side, and if it will be only bank balance or debit balance, so in this particular case you will write amount of bank balance in debit side just like cash. Okay, now see next transaction, that is on June 10 discounted a bills of exchange at 1% through bank. So very simple journal entry will be there, that is bank account debit, discounting charges account debit to bills receivable. Amount of bill is 5000 and it is discounted from the bank at 1%. So on 5000 at 1% amount will be 50. So we will receive 4950 from bank. So bank account debit to bills of exchange or to BR, this particular portion will come in cash book, and discount in charges account debit to bill receivable, this particular portion will come in journal proper. So apart from format of cash book, in such questions you have to prepare format of journal also. So such transactions will come in journal. Okay, so bank account debit to BR treatment will come in debit side to BR, and amount will come in bank column, that is 4950 and date was June 10. So always remember one thing, whenever you will prepare double column cash book, apart from format of cash book, you have to prepare format of journal also for writing entries of discount. Okay, now on June 15 cash sale rupees 6000, so cash account debit to sales account, simple treatment will come in debit side to sales account, and this is our cash sale, so amount will come in cash column, which is 6000. Okay, see next transaction, June 18 paid into bank rupees 3000. Once again this is contra entry. So whenever we will pay amount into our bank, entry will be bank account debit to cash, and such transactions will be treated as contra entry, and treatment of contra entries will come on both sides. So bank account debit to cash, treatment in debit side will come to cash account, and in the column of ledger folio we will denote it by C. C means contra, and we are depositing 3000 rupees. So 3000 rupees will come in bank column, date is June 18 by bank account. In the column of ledger folio I will denote it by C. C means contra, and amount will come in cash column, which is 3000. So always remember one thing, my dear students, whenever you write treatment of contra entry, don't forget to write C in ledger folio column, debit side as well as in credit side. And always remember one more thing, when you will write treatment in debit side, suppose you are writing to cash, so amount will come in bank column, and if you are writing treatment in credit side by bank, in this particular case amount will come in cash column. Okay.